Hello student, now today we will discuss about the growth pattern of the plant. We know that the entire growth of the plant and entire development of the growth and plant is depends upon the mineral elements. We know that there are different types of the mineral elements. We know that from the entire rock, smallest particle of the soil will be produced. This soil shows totally 46 types of the mineral elements. Out of these 46 types of the mineral elements, only 16 elements are essential for the plant growth and development, which are divided into two parts. That is the major element and minor element. What are the major element? For example, CHO, NPK, CAMG, they are required into the large proportion for the plant growth and development. Then second, minor elements, or it is also known as a trace element. These trace elements are also most useful, but they are required into the very small concentration for the growth and development of the plant body. Actually, what is the growth? Growth is, we know that growth is irreversible action. It depends on the entire stages of the growth. It is divided into cell division, cell enlargement, cell maturation, and cell specialization. For all the growth stages in the entire plant body or the part of the plant body, this growth takes place, or for this growth, these mineral elements are essential. Soil is the main source of this mineral element. How it takes place into the leaves, or how it takes place inside this plant body? Here, there is a concept of the ascent of sap. We know that in the soil capillary, soil water is present. In the soil water, these mineral elements are dissolved, and these dissolved mineral elements are taken through the root hairs, and through the root system, they are incorporated into the entire plant body through the transpiration process. So during the transpiration, a pool of different types of the mineral elements are distributed in all the plant body. But here, there are some elements which are in the gaseous form. We know that one of the most important element, there are different sources of the element. CHO, these are the inorganic elements. Then NPK, see the first, nitrogen. Nitrogen is the most important major element. These are nitrogen. What is the main source of the nitrogen? Main source of the nitrogen is not atmosphere, it is the soil. This nitrogen is always present in the gaseous form, but for the absorption or for the entire life cycle of the plant, nitrogen is always absorbed in the form of nitrate, nitrite, and ammonia. This nitrate, nitrate, ammonia, that is fixation of the nitrogen takes place. So after fixation of the nitrogen, this nitrogen combined into the soil or incorporated in the soil, then it is taken in the form of ammonical form or NH form or nitrate or nitrite. So actually main source of this nitrogen is nitrate, nitrite, and ammonia. There are different sources, but for all the sources, here fixation of the nitrogen is essential, and the fixation of the nitrogen takes place by different ways. There are mainly three processes. First, physical nitrogen fixation. In the physical nitrogen fixation, what happens? Here, due to the higher electricity during the lightening of process, reduction and oxidation takes place. And this reduction and oxidation, due to this reduction and oxidation, acid will be produced, and it is mixed in the soil, which is one of the natural source. Then second, chemical conversion of this nitrogen. This chemical conversion of the nitrogen always takes place into the fertilizer, that is different types of the fertilizers which are added into the soil. This is the second source. And third and most important source, that is the biological nitrogen fixation. This biological nitrogen fixation, it is again divided into symbiotic nitrogen fixation or asymbiotic nitrogen fixation. So by the three ways, this nitrogen get added into the soil in the form of nitrate, nitrite and ammonia. After utilization of the plant, by the plant, in the plant remains, REMAINS remains, that is, plant residue. It is now present in the form of the organic compound. Then, in the soil particle, this NH3 or this nitrogen compounds are present. After that, recycling takes place. So, after utilization of this nitrogen, which is utilized for the formation of the plant body, here decomposition takes place. But biological members, it may be symbiotic or non-symbiotic, generally in the non-symbiotic conversion, different types of the microorganisms, generally bacteria, they are responsible for the degradation of these plant parts. And after degradation, they are released into the soil and into the next life cycle, they are utilized. Here, these are the different sources. For example, lateral process, then inorganic fertilizers which are produced into the different fertilizer industry, nitrogen fixation process, then animal residue, crop residue, and organic fertilizers, that is organic method. Here, this soil organic matter, which contains a different types of the microorganism, here denitrification takes place. What is denitrification? Denitrification is nothing but removal of this nitrogen in the form of nitrate, nitrate, or ammonia. So, if you see the entire cycle of the nitrogen, this cycle shows utilization of the nitrogen. But how it is utilized? After formation of the different compounds through the different plants, this ammonia, nitrate and nitrate, they will be produced. One is that in the plants, in the leguminous plant, for example, in case of leaf, this utilization of the nitrogen takes place and nitrogen compounds are essential. Here, reduction of the nitrate takes place. But this reduction of the nitrate and nitrite takes place in presence of the enzyme. That is one of the special types of the enzyme which is responsible for the utilization of this NO3. Actually, that is the NH3 is converted into NO3 or NO2. That is a nitrate. This NO3 is converted into NO2. Then this NO2 is converted into NH2 or NH3 or NH4. This entire conversion is under control of the one of the most important enzyme which is present into the leaf. It is known as nitrate reductase enzyme. Due to this NR and NIR activity, this conversion takes place. Here, atmospheric denitrification is very simple. Organic utilization of nitrogen is very simple. But how this utilization takes place? Here, if you see the global reservoir, that is the protein molecule. One is that for the synthesis of the protein molecule, amino acids are essential. The synthesis of the amino acids are depends upon the transamination reactions. Actually, these nitrogen compounds are utilized for the synthesis of the amino acids. And this, what is actually protein molecule? Protein molecule is nothing but the different types of the molecule, different types of the amino acids, that is 20 types of the amino acids are combined together in the different sequences and the formation of the one protein molecule. So now this nitrogen, which is converted by, after ammonification, after transamination reaction, now it is utilized for the synthesis of the protein molecule. And this is actually nitrogen reservoir, and these protein molecules may be utilized for the different reactions. But overall, main source is atmosphere. What is the role of this nitrogen? Here, nitrogen is utilized by the bacteria and plant in the form of ammonia or ammonical compounds. Here it serves as the electron acceptor in anaerobic environmental condition. Then this nitrogen is the most elementary nutrient into the soil and water, and this nitrogen is a major key element in the amino acid. So entire synthesis of the amino acid depends upon the transamination reaction. For the synthesis of the transamination reaction, only amino group will be transferred, and due to the transamination reaction, remaining amino acid molecules or amino acids are synthesized within the plant, which are utilized. Here, the indirectly this nitrogen or protein molecules which are utilized for support for the nucleic acid synthesis. We know that nucleic acid contains RNA and DNA. Here purine and pyrimidine synthesis takes place, that is ATC and G. They are depends upon the nitrogen which is utilized here. Then in the bacteria, cellular formation takes place. In all the growth patterns, there is cell division, cell enlargement, utilization of this nitrogen compound takes place. So ammonification, mineralization, immobilization, nitrogen fixation, and nitrification and denitrification, this process takes place into, it is actually related with this compound. So for the synthesis of the amino acids, indirectly this nitrogen is utilized for the protein synthesis via synthesis of the amino acid, and these amino acids are utilized for the different process. For example, in the cell division, cell enlargement, cell maturation and cell specialization, this nitrogen is utilized in the form of NH3 NH4, but for that purpose NR and NR activity is essential. That is, nitrate reductase and nitrate reductase activity is essential, and it is only takes place in the leaves, not in the root. So entire nitrogen related work, that is protein synthesis, occurs into the leaf. So this is about the summarical part of the nitrogen compound. Okay.